To you,
No,
it did.
but I'm saying there was. Oh yeah, you're right. Yeah, sorry. Yeah, I was thinking of the wrong thing. But you know, you're absolutely correct. And they've managed to sort of be not Activision,
Yeah.
which is nice. But yeah, so if there's, you know, I think it would be ridiculous for companies now to start saying, you know, oh, I'm gonna release a game that's gonna be more popular than Call of Duty. No, release a good game.
Yeah.
Then the next guy will release a good game. Next guy game, and the next guy will release one. And pretty soon, you know, once you get, you know, if it turns out that in the next generation, Deep Down is good, and that 1885 7, whatever that game's called,
The Order 1886.
The Order 1886 is good, and then on the other console, you know, Titanfall is good. There's gonna be so many cool games, and no one will want to play Call of Duty, which is, you know, a nice thought. Well, we're gonna go to a quick break, and when we get back, we'll do StarCraft.
Yep.
All right, sounds good. Stay tuned for these messages.
Yep. Bye, guys.
Listen to your heart. Check out the Friday Morning Markout every Friday morning at 8 a.m. on CHMR 93.5 FM.
Tierra Nova Council 1452 of the Knights of Columbus holds bingo every Sunday and Wednesday nights at 8 p.m. sharp on St. Clair Avenue. Help support the Knights of Columbus, who help support our community.
Listening to 93.5 CHMR FM, Mon Radio, in stereo, baby! I'm in the
And we are back on 93.5 CHMR FM, and this is The Aperture, a weekly hour-long discussion of all topics geek culture. I'm one of your hosts, Rory DC.
And I'm your other host, Adam Porge Knight.
And
we're talking about Blizzard today, and
that's what we hope.
So, what's your favorite Blizzard flavor, Rory?
Oh my God, I'm trying to think actually now of what my favorite Blizzard flavor is at Dairy Queen.
Yeah,
excellent
frozen confectionery.
I seem to recall Oreo being really good.
I like their peanut butter Reese's cups, but I can't have it because my asshole friend is
Sandy.
Yeah, is allergic. So I can't
that's
have
why
it.
I don't have them either.
Yeah,
Sandy.
I only eat them when he's not around, but they're really, really good. So try the Reese's Pieces Blizzard. Yeah.
Do they still have the Oreo one?
Oh, the Oreo is like their staple Blizzard.
Like
man.
Oreo is really good. I like Oreo everything, to be honest.
Yeah, Oreo's good.
I sometimes don't like the modifications they make to the Oreo.
You mean
to make it like fancy
golden and, Oreo, whatever it was.
Or like they change it to make it like I don't know if you know this, but I'm not crazy about like the intentionally peppermint Oreos.
I like peppermint things,
really?
So I'm okay with that. But I understand what you're getting at.
Yeah, because it's like it's a little strong for me. You know, I just want to kick back and relax with my Oreos and watch a Tom Cruise movie.
Yeah.
But whatever.
We're way off topic.
Yes. I think I opened up when we were sort of talking about stuff vaguely gaming related. I said we were drastically off message, and now we're just in a whole other region altogether. But yeah, so today's show is ostensibly about Blizzard Entertainment, and before the break I said we'd talk about StarCraft, and we will.
Yeah, so StarCraft is my favorite game that Blizzard makes. I absolutely adore StarCraft. I first played StarCraft, interestingly enough, not on Windows or Mac OS, but on Nintendo 64, because it came out from the Nintendo 64, and it was one of the few games for that system that I didn't hate, because Nintendo 64 is an awful system. I hate it. Most of the games came out
really?
From that was... Yeah,
you know, like Mario Kart?
More friendships have been ruined over the bloody blue shell than anything else. It's like friggin' Monopoly.
It's like, I never played Monopoly. Yeah. It seemed drastically complicated to me.
Monopoly?
Yeah.
It's unnecessarily complicated. But anyway, did not like Nintendo 64, although StarCraft was excellent. StarCraft is an RTS game. That means real-time strategy. Basically, you have to manage your resources, build up your base, build up your army, and then go and defeat your enemies, which is either player characters or non-player characters, depending on, you know, what you're doing. There are three playable races. There's the Terrans, or the humans. There's the Protoss, which are kind of like the really high-technology aliens. And then there's the Zerg, which is kind of like the more animalistic aliens. Yeah. And each of them has their own niches that they churn out. The Terrans have more upgrades. The Protoss are very, very powerful, but you can't make many of them. And the Zerg are very, very cheap, but they're also not very powerful. Great system. There was a lot of... it's so popular to the fact that it's become a national sport of a country.
That's true.
Is it actually the national sport?
Well, I don't know if it's a national sport, but they at one point, I seem to recall, in the early days of like StarCraft, Wings of Redemption was talking about this on a video one time, like there would be channels that played nothing but StarCraft. And there would be like...
In South Korea.
Is it South Korea? Yeah, it is South Korea. Yeah. You're right. And apparently there would actually be like StarCraft reality TV shows, like where you would get like a pro at StarCraft.
Yeah.
And you would get him to go up against
like Ultimate Fighter.
Yeah, exactly. Well, except against instead of going against like other semi-amateur fighters or like intending to be pro fighters, they would go up against ordinary people. And apparently it was a huge source of embarrassment if you know, one of the pros lost the ordinary guys.
Yeah, well, because it's kind of like it was like a chess championship except, you know, they're like chess champions except instead of like
exactly.
like knight to rook 4, I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know how to play chess. It's boring.
And
you say there's a Zerg rush coming in. Deploy more siege tanks. And, and by siege tanks, I mean fire bats, because that's the appropriate response to a Zerg rush. Zergling rush.
Well, that's sort of one of the things. It really is like a sport.
Story. I'm currently playing through it again, because I played it a long time ago on the Nintendo 64. Sold that system, because honestly, who wouldn't?
Mario Kart.
No, Rory. The only worthwhile games for that was Star Fox and Super Smash Bros.
You know, I'm not inclined to disagree that those were great games either, actually, now that I'm thinking about it. But
you can keep your Ocarina of Time and your crappy camera controls.
Are we even like Ocarina of Time?
Crappy camera controls.
That's
good story,
okay,
though.
Yeah. No, that's one of those things. What is it with games and bad camera controls back in the days?
They had one analog stick. They had one.
That. Yeah, it's a terrible design.
You know, I blame Super Mario 64 because they designed the controller to be the best for that game, and they failed epically at it because they were like, let's have a fixed camera system because that's going to be excellent when you're jumping in three-dimensional spaces. No, it's hard as balls.
Well, I remember Adam laughed at me the first time he saw me pick up an N64 controller because like there really is no standardized way to hold it to my mind, but apparently there was.
There was.
And so like I had like my palms on top of it. Like I had a palm, my left palm was on the analog stick, and like my right finger was on the buttons, and that's what I would use, sort of almost like a very small, very awkwardly moving joystick. But it was interesting because I looked at the thing. I'm like, how do I hold this?
We're gonna have to talk about the N64 One show because I'll rage against that.
Oh, exactly.
But anyway.
We should have a show just on accessories, like controllers and eye things, you know, all those various
robots.
Eye things when they were coming out.
And Rob the robot.
Yeah, exactly. And every little thing we can think of in that regard.
But StarCraft, excellent story. The story is essentially your Terrans, the humans, as they're called, you were sent away from Earth on like a kind of like three colony ships. Something happened. You went through a wormhole. Isn't that just the way? Apparently, they met up with Starship Voyager.
Yeah.
went into a wormhole, and they ended up on the other side of the galaxy, and they just established what it became known as the Terran Dominion.
Yeah.
Then they started to run afoul of this alien race called the Zerg, and also because they were fighting the Zerg, that also drew the attention of the Protoss. There's this three-way war between the Terrans, the Protoss, and the Zerg, and I can't get any more story than that because we'll be here forever. But suffice to say, really cool story, a lot of cool characters.
Very, very cool.
But the gameplay is what hooked me. I love the units, I love the music, I love it. Like, it controls so well.
Mm-hmm.
It's such, like, I can't really remember what RTS games came out before StarCraft. I don't really know.
I wasn't really
probably something like Age of Empires or something like that.
Age of Empires 1.
But I feel like StarCraft again set the bar for how RTS should be handled on computer. And it's clear that it was successful due to its sheer popularity.
Yeah,
If World of Warcraft is the game of like the PC users of North America, then StarCraft is the game of choice for South Korean players.
Yeah.
They love it. Absolutely
exactly.
Love it.
Yeah, and it did do quite well in North America. I mean,
it's
impressive as well how big, like, the StarCraft online community. I don't mean, like, online gameplay. I'm talking about, like, YouTube and stuff like that.
Oh, yeah.
Like, dudes who play nothing but StarCraft. That is a huge market, and people don't realize, like, I sort of wish there was less of, like, every commentator playing Call of Duty.
Yeah.
So I'm like, come on, guys, play Resistance, play something, you know. Make it interesting. And so I have a lot of respect for StarCraft guys.
Yeah.
And those are, you can tell, like, if someone's playing nothing but StarCraft, they're not, like, you know, in it just for what's popular.
Yeah.
They're in it because they love StarCraft.
And to be fair, there's a lot to love about StarCraft.
And it makes it more interesting, you know, when someone